mic. Thanks.
Moses asked me to preach and he wouldn't give me the microphone.
Yeah, so Moses 让我讲，结果他没有把麦克风给我。
Good morning, New Life.
大家晚安。
I am so blessed and so honored to be able to share with you today here.
我今天很开心能够跟大家来分享。
And I see a lot of my friends and even my parents who is filming me right now.
我看到很多朋友，还有我自己的父母也坐在当中，正在为我拍照。
Thank you guys for coming.
我们感谢你们来到我们当中。
Today I want to share with you my sermon topic is best counselor ever.
今天我要跟大家分享的信息是超级顾问。
Best counselor ever.
超级顾问。
We know that in our society today, there are all sorts of counseling services available to us, right?
我们知道在我们现今社会中有非常这种顾问啊、咨商的这些服务。
Can you think of one on top of your head right now?
你们脑袋里想随便一种。
Moses, can you think of one?
Moses, 说一个吧。
Financial counselor.
理财顾问。
胡婆婆可以帮我想一个吗？理财顾问，
又是理财顾
问。Oh, yeah, health coach.
Yeah.
健康顾问。Yeah. 升学顾问 thank you.
Schooling advisors.、Right?
Yeah, so there are all sorts of advisor counseling services available to us.
所以有非常多种类的顾问咨询系统在我们生命当中。
And there are one counseling service that I have ever used.
其实我生命中只用过一种
，That is the school counselor.
那就是学校的咨询师。
So many years ago, I was still studying community college, and I wanted to transfer out to one of the UC schools.
所以在很多年以前呢，我在读社区大学的时候，我想要把我的学位升到外面的其他像 UC 的学校。
At that, well, there's something you need to know about me at that time.
但是我必须要先跟你介绍一下我是怎么样的人。
那个时候，
那个时候我是怎么样的人
？It's not me, no longer me now.
哦，不是现在的 Avon 哦，记得。
Yeah, but at that time, I had a lot of friends and we love eating out.
那时候 Avon 身边中有很多一些朋友是很爱跟他一起出去外面吃东西的。
We love singing karaoke and we even have Disney annual pass.
他们很喜欢在外面唱卡拉 OK， 而且他们有迪士尼的年票。
So instead of studying and doing our homework, we would drive to Roland Heights, San Gabriel, and sing karaoke.
所以其实我们常常没有在认真的上课，我们都是去 Roland Heights 啊，或者是圣伯谷那边去吃饭、去唱歌。
As you can imagine, my grade was not that pretty.
如果你能想象得到的话，我成绩并不是非常的好。
So I went to my school counseling, hoping that.He could give me some advice of transferring to one of the UCs.
所以呢，我就来到我学校去找我的那个升学顾问，希望他能告诉我，用这个成绩我怎么能申请上 UC.
Yeah, so after my school counseling review my grade and the classes that I've taken.
然后当那个升学顾问看到我上的课还有我的成绩的时候
，You know what he said to me?
你知道对我说什么吗
？He said, "Avon, with a grade like that."Don't even think about applying to any of the UC schools.
他说 ，Avon， 你看看你的成绩，用这个成绩，你别想申请任何加州大学的学校。
What you should do instead is to apply to these other schools where you have a better chance of transferring.
他说，你应该做的呢，是看看其他的这些学校，这些学校你比较有机会申请上。
At that time, I was so shocked.And so scared, I feel like I have failed my parents.
在当下，我觉得我好震惊，我好失望，我觉得我让我的家族蒙羞。
Because they've sacrificed so much to bring me and my brothers here, hoping that we could get into a good school.
因为我的父母，他们牺牲好多，就是把我们全家带来美国，希望我们可以用上大学来往社会往上一阶走。
So I went home and I told my mom that.
我回家就跟我母亲说
My mom, on the other hand, she's kind of the life advisor for me, too.
但是另一方面，我妈妈是我生命的顾问。
If you know her, she's the amazing grace sitting here.
如果你知道吗？我们都叫她奇异恩典。
She is the God-fearing woman who is full of faith.
她是一个充满信心、属神的女子。
And She said to me, "Well, don't listen to your school counselor."
她对 Avon 说，别听你那个升学顾问的。
If God wants you to get into a good school, He will make that happen.
如果神要让你进去一个好学校，那神会这么做的。
So go ahead and apply to all the UC school, even those school that you didn't think you can get into.
他说 ，Avon， 你给我申请所有 UC 的学校，任何你觉得你根本不可能进的，你都给我申请下去。
And guess whose advice I listened to?
你们猜 Avon 听了谁的建议？
Yes, I listened to my mom's advice. That is why today I can tell you that I graduated from UC Berkeley.
Yeah, 因为 Avon 听了她母亲的建议，所以她最后也顺利的从伯克莱大学毕业了。
Yeah. So it is a miracle because we know with a grade like that, there's no way. It must be God.
这是一个神迹，因为我们自己都心知肚明。让 Avon 能够毕业，简直就需要神的帮助。
So what if you might be thinking, what if you don't have someone like my mom in your life who can give you good advice when you need it?
你可能会想，可是我生命当中没有像 Avon 母亲的角色，那当我遇到困难的时候，我该怎么办呢？
Well, today I am sharing a good news with you.
今天我就要来跟你分享这个好消息。
Because each and every one of us has been given a wonderful counselor.
因为其实我们在座的每个人，神都已经给我们一个超级顾问。
And this wonderful counselor is our Jesus Christ.
而这个超级顾问呢，就是我们的主耶稣基督。
Let me read you Isaiah. Oops, sorry. Okay, let's read Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6 together.
让我们一起来读以赛亚书九章六节。
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
因有一个婴孩为我们而生，有一子赐给我们，政权必担在他的肩膀上。他名称为奇妙策士，全能的神，永在的父，和平的君。
Note here that there are four attributes of Jesus that it has mentioned here in this scripture.
在这边有四个给耶稣的一个 title.
Well, for the mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, I heard a lot in our worship songs, right?
关于全能神永在的父和平的君，我们在很多敬拜的歌都听得到。
But this wonderful counselor seems to be kind of out of place in this scripture.
但这个奇妙策士好像放在这里怪怪的。
So I was wondering, could it be that it actually means something else? Maybe we lost the translation when we translate the original Bible to English or Chinese.
所以当下我就在想说，也许可能是翻译错误吧，它可能是代表别的意思哦。
So I actually did some research on the word counselor.
所以我就去做了一点点 的研究，来看这个顾问这个词。
The word counselor in Hebrew it's look like this.
在希伯来文里面 ，counselor 顾问是长这样子，是从右边读到左边的。
It means Yaetz. Oh, I mean, it's pronounced Yaetz.
它念起来是 Yaetz.
And guess what it means?
你们猜它什么意思呢
？It means to counsel.
它就是顾问的意思。
So the wonderful counselor in Bible actually means.Wonderful Counselor.
所以当圣经讲说奇妙策士的时候，它真的就在指耶稣是我们的奇妙策士。
When I learned about that, I just see God's goodness in this.
当我看到这个经文的时候，我就看到神摆在这当中很美妙的安排。
Because God knows that on earth, every day we face different kinds of challenges.
因为神知道我们在地上每天都经历不同种类的困难。
When we make a wrong move, it could bring a lot of trouble into our lives.
当我们做错一件事情，可能就有很多随之而来的灾难进到我们当中。
But God didn't want us to do this alone.
但神不希望我们自己去面对。
So He sent us this wonderful counselor to help us out in this life journey.
所以神就把超级顾问赐给我们。
Now I want to show you what the wisest person of the world says about counselor.
在这世界上曾经最有智慧的人是这样如此说的。
Let me read you Proverbs. It says, Plans fail for lack of counsel, but with many advisors, they succeed.
他说，不先商议，所谋无效。 谋事众多，叟谋乃成。
So the word that I use, read, advisor, it's actually the word that we just saw. It's also ya'etz.
刚上面这个红色的谋事，就跟你们刚刚看到 ya'etz 是同一个词。
So note here that King Solomon, he is the wisest person of the world.
所罗门王是我们知道所知最有智慧的人，他是这么说。
He didn't say that.In order to be successful, you need a lot of wisdom.
他并没有说，如果你要成功，你必须要充满智慧如我。
He is also the wealthiest person of the world.
你知道吗？他也是世界上最有财富的人。
But he also didn't say that in order to be successful, you need to have a lot of wealth.
所罗门王也没有说，如果你想成功，你必须要有钱如我。
It says here, with many counseling, they succeed.
但是有智慧的所罗门王他说谋事正多，所谋乃成。
So having a good counseling in our life is really essential in living a successful life.
所以你生命当中要有很多的谋士，很多的顾问，你才有办法成功。
So, we do have so many counseling services available to us in the society, right?
在今天我们有很多这样的服务，对吧？
What makes Jesus different from all of that?
但耶稣跟他们不同在哪里呢？
Today I want to introduce you Jesus as our best counselor ever.
今天我就要让你们来认识耶稣，是我们那位超级顾问。
And here's why.
现在就是为什么呢？
This wonderful counselor counsels you with love.
因为这位超级顾问是以爱为出发点。
Let's read Psalm chapter 32, verse 8.
Yeah.
I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my loving eye on you.
诗篇三十二篇八节这么说：我要教导你，指示你当行的路；我要定睛在你身上劝诫你。
I love the English translation here because it says God will be like.Watching over us with his loving eye on us.
这句经节说，神会用他爱慕的眼神来盯着我们看。
That means he knows our past, present, and future, and he's also like watching us out of his love for us.
这代表说，他不但能看到我们的过去、现在跟未来，他还是充满的爱来看着我们前方的路。
If there's this counselor who knows what's going to happen to me in the future.And he also, I know that he's like so in love with me, I would definitely want to listen to his advice.
如果你身边中有一个顾问，他是知道未来、知道过去的，而他又那么爱你，你绝对要听他给你的建议。
And personally, I have experienced that.
你知道我生命当中也如此经历过。
Back to my Berkeley story.
回到我刚伯克莱大学的故事。
You know, like when people get into Berkeley, it's because they're either super smart,Or they study super hard.
你们知道吗？在 UC Berkeley 这种学校里面，大概只有两种人，要么就是他们超级聪明，要么他们超会读书。
But I'm neither one of those.
但是 Avon 不是任何一种。
I got into Berkeley by God's grace and miracle.
他靠的完全就是上帝给他的恩典与奇迹。
As you can probably guess, the first semester was so hard.
你们能想象第一个学期简直灾难。
I remember having to take this one economic class in order to be able to get into the major of economics.
为了要进去经济系这个专业，我必须第一个学期的时候认真上这个经济的课。
And I have to receive at least a B minus for this specific class.
而这堂课呢，我必须要达到 B minus 这个成绩，我才有办法。B minus 不高。
Wow, thank you. Yeah, but however, I remember taking the first exam and it was so hard.
我记得我第一次考试的时候，这是在写什么？
I turned in like almost a blank exam back to my professor.
基本上，那个考试卷怎么来的，我就怎么样还给老师。
So my grade was way below class average.
所以呢，我比班上的平均值还要低的非常多。
That means I'm failing the class.
这代表我不会成功得到 B minus.
After A few weeks, the class didn't get any easier. It only got harder.
接下来几个礼拜呢，并没有越来越容易，反而更难了。
So some of my friends, they approach me. They're like, Avon, we can't do this. We're dropping this class.
然后我这些朋友们呢，就来到我当中说 ，Avon, 我们觉得我们应该撑不下去，我们可能就先放弃这堂课吧。
Yeah, we're going to change to other major that you probably have never heard of.
我们要去换一些专业，是那些你从来没听过的那些专业。
At that time, I thought, oh, I should definitely do that too because I'm failing the class.
Avon 就说啊，既然你们都要这样的，也许我也该这么做，因为我成绩那么糟。
And I was thinking that once I drop the class, the first semester will be so easy for me, and I can hang out with these people.
我想说，如果我今天跟他们一样放弃这堂课，那这个学期就会简单很多，我就可以跟我的朋友们继续出去玩。
So I was going to do that, but before I went and do that,
我原本是打算这么做，但在我做这件决定之前
，I went to my wonderful counselor.
我来到我的超级顾问面前。
And I made a prayer. I told God what I was about to do. I was about to drop the class.
我就跟神祷告说，神啊，你知道的，我很想把这堂课给放弃掉。
And right after I made the prayer, I have this strong conviction coming to my heart.
当天祷告完的时候，我生命当中有一个很大谴责的声音在里面。
I feel like God said, "You are just running away from your problem."
他说 ，Avon。你只是在从你的问题面前逃跑而已。
And all of a sudden, I was like awakened.
当下，他忽然就清醒过来。
I was like,、oh, "You are right. I just wanted to have an easy way out."
他说：“神啊，你对了，我其实就只是想逃跑而已。
When I should have just faced my challenge, instead, I wanted to run away.
我应该要面对我的问题，但是我选择逃跑。
At that time, I knew what I was supposed to do.
当下，我就知道我该怎么做。
Even though it risks.The fact that I might fail the class and I might drop out of Berkeley.
然后，即便说我可能会因为这堂课的失败而从伯克莱大学被踢出去。
And that is where I want to give a shout out to our prayer team.
这个时候，我需要给所有祷告的同工们一个掌声。
I know that a lot of you guys have been praying for me, requested by my mom while I was in Berkeley.
我知道当时有很多教会爱祷告的弟兄姐妹为我的成绩来祷告。
And my mom told me that even during my final exam, there were people praying at the same time in Irvine for me.
Avon 妈妈当下还召集了一群人在 Avon 考试的过程里面为她祷告。
Because of that, in the end, I ended up getting.A B minus for the class.
因为这个神奇妙的祷告带领，所以 Avon 最后有得到他需要的 B minus.
I remember on the last day of class.
我记得上课的最后一天。
The professor gave us a warning.
我们的教授给我们了一个提醒。
He said, "You guys don't even come and ask me for a better grade."
他说你们别给我过来跟我要求升级。
This is the first time ever that I have ever given out so many A's and B's.
这是史上第一次我给这么多 A 跟 B 的。
At that time, I knew it was God.
当下我就知道那是神。
Because my grade was always below average, I deserve a fail of this class.
因为我知道我的成绩低于平均值，我应该要被唾弃的。
Yeah, but don't you see God's goodness in this?
你没有看到神奇妙的带领吗？
His love, you know.He loves me so much for me to run away from my problem.
他爱我们那么多，让我们不会从我们的问题面前逃跑。
Out of his love, he brought this conviction to me, letting me know that I have the ability to overcome this class.
因为他的爱，他让你知道你有能力面对你面前的问题。
And where I wasn't able, he did miracle for me.
就在我们做不到的过程里面，他会行神迹在我们当中。
That's how loving our God is.
这就是神如此的爱我们。
And that He knows your past, present, and future.
并且他知道你的过去、现在跟未来。
And that's not all.
那不是唯一的哦。
Sorry. Okay. This wonderful counselor actually desires a personal relationship with us.
这位超级顾问，他其实非常想与你建立一个亲密的关系。
And he's so willing to give us help when we need it.
他非常愿意在我们需要的时候给我们提供需要的帮助。
In Matthew chapter 11, verse 28 says,
马太福音十一章 28节这么说
Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest.
凡劳苦担重担的可以来到我这里，我就使你们得安息。
That is how good our God is.
这就是我们的神如此对我们那么好。
Just like Moses was saying during our worship earlier today.
就像 Moses 今天在带敬拜的时候说的。
This wonderful counselor, when you bring your burden to him,
当你把你的重担给这个超级顾问的时候，
he would love to take that and give you peace, give you rest.
他会把你重担换过来，交换给你的是那个安息，是那个休息。
And that's true for me too.
是在 Avon 的生命当中也是如此。
I remember a few days ago when I was at work.
我记得几天前我在上班的时候，
I received a text message from one of our sisters in our small group.
当天我就收到了一个简讯，是从我们小组的小组员来的。
After reading that text message, I just felt so frustrated and upset.
我读完的时候就非常充满了困惑，并且很难过。
It was an urgent prayer request for her family overseas.
那是一个紧急的代祷。为他在在海外的家人们的祷告。
I was so upset to a point that I couldn't work.
因为这个简讯，我焦虑到没有办法工作。
So I went out and take a walk around the business building.
因为这样子，我就决定去在我的办公室附近散步。
So I have this habit when I go out and take a walk.
所以每次我有一个习惯，当我出去散步的时候。
I would imagine Jesus walking next to me.
我就想象耶稣就在我旁边。
So I'm like walking with Jesus.
所以我就这样跟耶稣一起走路。
And I would talk to him like there's an actual person walking next to me.
我就像这样对耶稣说话，假如他就在我身边。
So I was venting to Jesus. I was like, this doesn't make sense. Why is this happening to our sister's family?
所以我就在这样子跟耶稣一直抱怨说，怎么会有这种状况在我们姐妹的身上发生？
And when I was still walking,
当我还在散步的过程，
I felt this sense of peace coming to me.
却有一个超出人意外的平安临到我的身上。
I feel like God says, "Hey, don't worry."
神对我说， "Hey, 你不要担心。
This sister's family are in my hand."
他说，这位姐妹的家人也在我的手上。
I will take care of them. Don't worry about it.
我必亲自带领他们，你不用担心。
So even though I was still pretty upset, I was able to feel this sense of peace.
虽然我非常非常的难过，但是我体验到神给我的平安。
So I went back to work.
我就回到我的办公室。
And later that evening, the sister updated us about the situation.
当天快傍晚的时候，那位姐妹就再次跟我们提起现在的状况。
Turned out the things that were concerned was resolved.
感谢神，我们那些原本需要的祷告事项，神都已经安排好了。
Yeah, so if God can do that to us, He's so willing to do the same thing for you.
如果神愿意在我生命上这样做的话，神也愿意在你们每个人的生命中如此行。
I want to encourage us. If you have any burden, just bring it to Him. He would love to trade that and give you peace instead.
你们任何有劳苦背重担的，都要到耶稣面前来。他愿意把你们的重担换取平安。
And new life, I feel like today God really wants to remind us.
今天神想要提醒新生命的每一个人。
He actually loves to talk to us firsthand.
他想要亲耳让你亲耳听到他对你所说的话。
I know that we're a church that value prophetic word.
我们教会非常在乎这个先知性的启示。
Personally, I've also been blessed by Pastor Gary Hayes' prophetic prayer a few weeks ago.
几个礼拜前，我也是被 Pastor Gary Hayes 这样子祝福过。
But do you know that we're each given a wonderful counselor who desires to speak to our heart himself?
但你知道吗？其实神赐给我们的这个超级顾问是能够让你亲耳能够听见神要对你说的话的。
Yeah, but now you might be wondering how.
那你现在想怎么做呢？
We know that the counseling services in our society, we can probably make a call or make an appointment.
你知道吗？在世界当中的这些咨商机构，你大概要做就打通电话来做一个appointment.
But how do we make an appointment or how do we come to our wonderful counselor for advice?
那我们面对这个超级顾问，我们要怎么预约呢？
Well, right now I want you to take a minute, well, take 10 seconds to think of something that has been on your heart and you would need advice from God.
在接下来的十秒钟里面，我们邀请你闭上双眼来思想你生命中需要神来帮助你的事情。十秒钟。
Because God is so willing and actually it's super easy for us to receive his counsel.
因为神很愿意，而且其实这么做是很容易的，我们是可以从神那边得到他的答案。
So let me tell you how with this verse.
让我来告诉你怎么来做。
If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who give generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you.
雅各书一章五节这么说，他说你们中间若有缺少智慧的，应当求那厚赐与恩人、厚赐与众人他不斥责人的神，主必赐给他。
It says here, ask God.
他说跟神求啊。
It's very straightforward and very simple.
他讲得很简单，跟神求。
And that's not the best part.
那并不是最好的一个部分。
You see the place where I underlined it?
你看到那个画底线的那样。
It says he's so willing to give to us without finding fault.
他说他给我们的时候，他不斥责人。
So when we come to him, we don't need to come with any fear.
所以当我们来到他面前的时候，我们不应该带着惧怕。
Because when we come, you know, God is not going to be like, oh, wow, look who decided to finally talk to me.
你知道吗？我们到神面前的时候，他不会很讽刺地说，哦，哟，你终于来了。
Or, when is the last time you pick up your Bible again?
他会说，诶，是不是该读圣经了？好久没碰了吧？灰尘很多。
Or, how come you didn't pray to me for a while?
他说，你怎么那么久没有来跟我祷告？
No, that's not our God.
我们神不会这么做。
Here it says, He gives generously to all without finding fault.
他说 他应当求那 厚赐与众人的神，也不斥责人的神。
It says generously to all, and not generously to those who spend 3 hours praying every day.
他说他要厚赐于每一个人，不是只有那些每天花3个小时祷告的那一批人。
It says he gives generously to all, but he didn't say to give generously to those who memorize the whole Bible.
他说他赐福于众人，并不是只是那些把所有圣经牢记在脑海里的那群人。
So all we have to do is just to ask God.
我们要做的就是跟神求。
So I want to encourage you, the thing that we just thought about in our heart that was concerning us.
所以我们刚刚十秒钟里面想那些你需要神帮助的事情。
Anytime, just ask God.
任何时候你准备好了，跟神求。
And I know that a lot of us are doing the heart and key fasting.
我知道我们在座很多人当中，我们都有一起在加入禁食。
Do you know that when we fast, we are more in tune with God?
你知道吗？当你在禁食的时候，你是与神更加对齐的。
So that it is a lot easier for us to receive from God.
在禁食的过程，你更容易聆听到神对你说的轻声细语。
That's personal, true to me as well.
在我的生命当中也是如此。
During this 20 or so fasting,
在这21天的禁食过程，
I did feel like my mind is sharper and I can receive from God a lot easier.
我感受到我脑袋非常的清晰，并且很容易就能得到神要赐给我的启示。
To be honest, recently I don't feel like I am doing well.
诚实的跟各位说，这段时间里我并不觉得我混得很好。
I feel like God asked me to have run this small business.
神曾经告诉我说，我要做一个小的一个公司。
But recently the business was not doing well. The sales has been really slow.
但神叫我经营的这个公司，这段时间，它的销售额非常的差。
So I was really confused, and there was a time I felt like maybe I need to go look for a job.
因为如此，我非常非常的困惑与焦虑。我甚至一度觉得我应该去外面找其他工作。
And that's what I did. I sent out some resume. I sent out my portfolio link.
我就是这么做的。那时候我去把我的那个 resume update 去寄给了很多公司。
But what I experienced was closed door after another closed door.
但我经历到了却是一扇一扇一扇的门为我关闭。
So I feel like God didn't want me to look for a job, but then He's not also blessing me financially from using my business.
所以我发现神不断的在给我外面的去外面找工作这件事情关门。但他却没有把我的需求用在我的公司里面给我祝福。
I was so disappointed and I was so confused.
我很失望，我也很困惑。
So I decided a few days ago that I am going to bring this concern to God.
所以几天前，我决定把我这个焦虑我带到神的面前。
I went to this wonderful counselor and I was just venting on him.
我来到我的超级顾问面前，我就再次与他抱怨。
I told him, hey, I stand on the stage to preach about tithing like almost every week, and you're not blessing me.
他说，天哪，上帝，我几乎每个周末都在这个舞台上讲关于奉献的信息，你怎么没有祝福我？
You promise when we give you, you're going to open the floodgates of heaven. Where is my floodgates of heaven?
你不是说你要敞开天上的窗户，让我们无处可藏，得到你给我们的祝福吗？
How do I become a testimony when I'm following you and I'm not seeing things coming through?
如果我都那么追寻，竭力追寻你，我却没有办法得到这祝福，你让我怎么成为你生命中的榜样？
So at that time, I felt like God reminded me.The story of Abraham.
就在这祷告的过程里面，神启示了我亚伯拉罕的故事。
Abraham and Sarah were also promised to have a son.
亚伯拉罕和他妻子撒来，从神那边得到启示说，要给他们一个孩子。
But at that time, they're in such an old age, it's almost impossible for Sarah to give birth to a son.
当时他们已经年近百，所以他们很难能够生育生出孩子。
So after waiting for many years, Abraham decided to take things on his own.
所以又过了很多年，事情都没有发生，亚伯拉罕决定以自己的方式来完成这份应许。
So he gave birth to a son through a servant girl.
所以他借由他太太的一个他太太的一位仆人。得到了另外一个孩子。
But that wasn't God's original promise, and that has caused a lot of consequences and trouble in Abraham's life.
但亚伯拉罕做的这件事情并不是神原本要给他的应许，所以这反而在后面给他了其他的困扰。
In the end, Abraham and Sarah did receive their son Isaac.
但是故事的最后，亚伯拉罕跟他的太太撒来真的从神得到神应许给他们的孩子。
During my quiet time, I feel like God used that story to remind me.
就在我跟神有亲密关系的时候，神用那个故事再一次对我生命说话。
To keep trusting on Him and not to make things happen on my own.
神说，你要信任我，并不是靠自己的力量把这个事情完成。
So before I spend time with God, I actually feel confused and frustrated.
其实在我跟神说这些话之前，我非常的困惑，非常的失望。
But after coming to this wonderful counselor, he gave me empowerment and he gave me hope.
但来到这超级顾问面前，他给我的力量，他给我的盼望。
So for the rest of the fasting, or even for the rest of your life.
所以在接下来的进食的过程，或者在接下来你人生当中
，I want to encourage us when we come to Jesus.See him as our wonderful counselor.
我要鼓励你们，每当想起耶稣的时候，记得他是你的超级顾问，你的奇妙测试。
And he will counsel you with his loving eye on you.
他给你的建议是因为他用爱你的眼神看着你。
He knows your past, present, and future.
他知道你过去、现在跟未来。
He loves to build this relationship with you.
他并且想要跟你建立一个亲密的关系。
Let us pray.
我们一起来祷告。
Dear God,
亲爱的天父
，Thank you that
我们感谢你。
You have this wonderful attribute of being our wonderful counselor.
感谢你就是我们那个奇妙的测试，超级的顾问。
Because you didn't want us to do things on our own.
你并不希望我们靠自己的力量来完成。
You're so willing to help us, and with your love always watching us.
你的爱永远环绕我们，你眼睛定睛在我们身上。
So I want to bring my brothers and sisters to your throne.
我们今天把弟兄姐妹一起来到你的宝座面前。
Would you provide the help that and the wisdom that we need?
求你今天就把智慧跟帮助放在他们当中。
Would you open our ear and our eyes and our hearts to see you as our wonderful counselor?
求你打开我们的双眼，打开我们的双耳，让我们能够认识你就是那奇妙的测试。
Whom we can go to without the fear of having any fault.
是那位我们不用害怕，因为你不会斥责我们的那位。
Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray.
感谢你。
Amen.
奉耶稣基督的名我们祷告。Amen.
Amen. So if any of you, you would like to be able to hear God better, I would like to encourage you to come to the altar. We would love to pray for you.
如果你也想亲自听到神对你说话，我们邀请你来到台前，我们要为你祷告。
And let us stand and worship God.
让我们一起起立，一起来敬拜他。